After the visit of Chief of Southern Command General John Kelly, he and the Honduran government said that 2014 was a positive year. They claim much of this was due to the United States Army, which is strengthening its historical strong presence in the country, especially in the past 5 years.
La visita de un militar del rango del jefe del Comando Sur.
The visit of a soldier with the rank of a Chief of Southern Command would be something exceptional in a country that is not a military base for the United States. But in my opinion, Honduras is an operative military base. We have Palmarola, but there are also 5 other operation centers, and they are all connected with different United States agencies, including the DEA, Drug Control Agency, that has become the biggest drug problem in our region.
Que se ha convertido en el problema más grande del narcotráfico en toda nuestra región.
The Palmarola military base, located in the center of Honduras, has been in use since the 1980s by the United States Army, that normally has more than 600 soldiers permanently stationed there. And since the 2009 coup d'etat, the United States has increased its presence, claiming it is there to fight the drug war, and currently has 6 control points in the country.
Who set the tone here is the United States, through their interference from their embassy in Tegucigalpa. And achievements for whom? That's what's not said. Achievements for the people? Or achievements for a small group of oligarchs? Or achievements for American interests here in Honduras?
Oligarcas y logros para los intereses norteamericanos aquí en Honduras.
The visit of the Chief of the Southern Command to Honduras has reaffirmed the support of the government of Juan Hernández in exchange of having one of the principal headquarters of one of their 31 military operations in Latin America. Gerardo Torres, Telesur, Central America.